best boxing content, don't forget to like, subscribe, and punch that bell for notifications.
Japan has always been a powerhouse in boxing. They are world leaders in producing champions and have a large stake of current world title holders with names like Naoya Inoue, Kazuto Ioka, and the man that has been credited as a national fisticuffs hero, Ryota Murata. He is also an Olympic gold medalist, fights in a premier division, and provides a punch-first style that keeps fans and opponents on their toes. However, while his compatriots have remained active, the former WBA champion is sitting at 35 years old with over a year of inactivity, and his time as a top dog in the middleweight division is running out. Murata has enjoyed a nice run, garnering attention from the boxing world and big brands. His amateur resume earned him a sponsorship deal with Nike as the face of one of their global campaigns. He was knocking people out and smiling on national television, rocking the swoosh apparel the whole time. But the lengthy six-footer has faced adversity throughout his career. In 2017, he lost his first world title shot via controversial split decision against a crafty veteran, Hassan Ndam. In the rematch, he left nothing to chance by finishing him within 7 rounds. This earned him Boxer of the Year honors from the Japan Boxing Commission and thrust him onto the world scene. A year later, he would put his title on the line twice more, once in Japan where he added another KO and the other in the States where he was matched up against 23-1 KO artist Rob Brandt. Brandt put on an inspiring performance, securing the unanimous decision and taking the title away from Murata once again. But just like the last time it was stolen away from him, he bounced back. In the rematch with Brandt, in front of a home crowd, he channeled his old ways. It took Murata just under 6 minutes to bring the gold back to its rightful owner. Before the pandemic hit, Murata was scheduled to face undefeated Canadian contender Patrice Volney. That fell through the cracks because of travel restrictions and forced the Tokyo native to the sidelines while COVID-19 ran its course. But patience is a virtue, and the layoff may have set up Murata for the biggest money fight of his career in future Hall of Famer Gennadiy Golovkin. The date and place that is being thrown around is December 28th in Tokyo, Japan, which would surely be appointment viewing. A win over Triple G isn't unrealistic. Murata provides the power, speed, experience, and determination needed to take down a legend like the Ironclad Kazakh. A win over one of the best to ever do it would not only put his name into every household around the world, but it would put Murata into the history books. The 160-pound division is stacked and only getting better. At the age of 35 and what will be 2 years of inactivity, Murata's time at the top of the rankings is running out. But he is used to adversity. He has been knocked down before, only to get back up and knock his opponents out. If he can get back to that form, it'll be one of the most impressive boxing runs, not only for Japanese fighters, but across the globe.